I've trained myself to listen to the river, not in the belief I could understand what it said, but just from one day to the next, know its fate. And I could hear notes that I'd never heard before. One of the reasons I live in Oregon is because of the beautiful rivers. Columbia to the ocean, Willamette and Portland. Gold Beach, the great Rogue River.
Welcome to the Portland Storytellers Guild October show in Clinton Street Theater. Yes! Please welcome Will Horniak.
Thank you, dear. How you doing tonight?
Good.
All right. So good to be here. I love rivers. And one of the reasons I live in Oregon is because of the beautiful rivers. I live near the Willamette. I live in Milwaukee. And when I leave Portland, I never feel like I arrive home until I go down to the Willamette River and I smell that certain combination of mud and rotten cottonwood leaves in the river. And I hear that first great blue heron whose solitude I disturb as it says, "Rah! Rah! Rah!" And there's 110,994 miles of creeks, streams, and rivers in Oregon. It's amazing. Mr. Google told me that, so I know it's true. But imagine that, 110,000. And the story I'm gonna tell you tonight from Barry Lopez, it has a beautiful line in it. I think it's a beautiful line. He says, to put your hand into the river is to feel the cords that bind the earth together. And Oregon has many cords that bind it together. And sometimes when I can't sleep, one thing I do is I lay in bed, and I close my eyes, and I try to imagine all the rivers of Oregon and see if I can name them and imagine where they all run. So I want to do that tonight to start. It's called the Oregon River Reverie. Don't say it fast 10 times. It's not going to work. So imagine that this is Oregon up here, and we're in southeast Oregon right here. You'd be in Northern California out there, okay? So out of the Owyhee, out of the Independence Mountains of Nevada comes the Owyhee River. It flows through Idaho. It cuts canyons 1,000 feet deep and runs 200 miles through Oregon and drains to the Snake River. And then from the Great Steens Mountain, the Donner River flows to the Blitzen, and the Blitzen cuts a swath 30 miles through high desert to Malheur Lake. And then from the eastern face of Elkhorns and Blues comes the Powder, the Burnt, and the Malheur River to Snake. And from the Great Wallowa Mountains back here in northeastern Oregon, from the Eagle Cap Wilderness comes Lostine River. Lostine flows to Wallowa River, to Minim, to Grand Ronde, and Grand Ronde flows to Snake, but before it gets there, the Wenaha comes into that. And then from right through the heart of the Wallowas comes the Imnaha River through the timbered uplands to the Columbia River Plateau and to the Snake. And then the Great Snake flows to Columbia. And here's the northern border of Oregon, Columbia running east to west. And as it does, it carries the Umatilla River from the Blue Mountains to the Columbia. And then from the Blues and the Ochocos comes the North Fork, Middle Fork, South Fork of John Day, 300 miles of river that flow from forested uplands through basalt canyons to Columbia. And then the Crooked River here, it twines through the Ochocos. And the Deschutes River dances from high cascades. The Metolius bubbles from a spring on eastern flank of Cascades. And all three twine and meet at Lake Billy Chinook. That becomes the main stem of Deschutes that flows 100 miles north to Columbia. And then closer to us, from the north face of Mount Hood, the Hood River falls swiftly to Columbia. And from the south face of Mount Hood, Salmon River meets Sandy River, Sandy to Columbia. Then from western face of Cascades, Mackenzie, Kalapuya, Santiam, Malala, Clackamas to Willamette. From eastern face of coastal mountains comes the Long Tom River, Yamhill River, Tualatin River to Willamette, and finally Willamette at Portland to the Columbia. From the northern face of coastal mountains comes Klatskanai River, and also Young's River all the way to Young's Bay at Astoria, and finally Columbia to the ocean. And then here at Astoria, looking south from the western face of the coastal mountains, comes the Neconicum River and Nehalem River to Nehalem Bay. then Miami and Kilchis and Wilson and Trask and Tillamook to the great estuary of Tillamook. And then further south, Nestucca, big and little, of course, come to Nestucca Bay. And just south of that, the beautiful coastal Salmon River flows into the great estuary at the base of Cascade Head. And then Alsea, and then Yaquina, and then Siusla at Florence, the dune country of Oregon. And then south of there, the beautiful Umpqua River. North Umpqua, born of the Western Cascades, flows and cuts through coastal mountains, becomes South Umpqua, and that picks up Smith River and then flows at Reedsport to Ocean. And just south of that, Coos River to Coos Bay. And south of there, the beautiful Coquille River meanders through coastal valleys to the Bandon estuary to the sea. South of there, the coastal rivers, the coastal mountains are the Siskiyous. Entwining, threading through steep Siskiyous comes Elk and Sixes, and then at Gold Beach, the great Rogue River. From the Western Cascades through Siskiyous, picks up the wild Illinois and drains to the ocean. And south of there, finally the Chetco River through Siskiyous to Brookings Harbor. But from southeastern Cascades comes Williamson and Sprague to the Klamath Lake, Klamath Lake to Klamath River, through Oregon to Northern California, Siskiyous to the ocean. Those are the cords that bind the earth of Oregon together. I think I should go back and tell my fourth grade teacher I finally did get geography, you know.